understand the spiritual meaning of Python to be demonic, the dance of Satan. But these guys are killing people. Who is buying AK-47 for them? If the government refuses to defend us, we will defend ourselves. And this will be the last time any Christian anywhere, not only in Nigeria or in the world, will be killed. If they kill any Christians, Christians will retaliate. The best way, listen, the best way to do that, the best way to do that is not to keep quiet. In the days of Jesus, the Bible said Peter was carrying a sword. When they arrested Jesus, Peter struck them. Why? That was not the first time the church was attacked. So the church began to harm themselves. If the government cannot protect us, we will protect ourselves. And if they kill any Christians, the Christians will retaliate. No more keeping quiet anymore. All of us own this country. And the way, if the righteous sit on the throne, the people will rejoice. But when the wicked sit on the throne, a lot of wicked things will happen. And that's why, don't say, I'm a Christian, I don't vote. If you don't vote, other people will vote and decide your fate. It is the people who are at the gate that decide the city, that decide what happens to other people. Number one, if you are a member of this commission, go and get voter's card. Are you hearing me? A voter's card. Nigeria is so that Christians, they are so that pastors are afraid to speak. If a pastor speak, they will set the pastor up. They will say things against the pastor. They will use the media. We are not afraid. Raise people, raise media. I will build my church, and the gate of hell shall not prevail. And again, nobody should eat cow. Their cow is more important than our life. For you to continue to buy cow, you are giving Fulani more money for more bullets for your burial. From now on, are you hearing me?
Yes, sir.
You can eat any other thing. Don't eat cow. Because to them, their cow is more important. Lift up your hands. What an insensitive people. On top of that, some of the APC governor went to endorse the president for second term. Where people are dying. You know what it means? It's dancing over the grave of those who have been murdered. Get your voter's card. We will decide who rules this country. We will decide. And we'll show them that the life of every Christian is sacred. I'm ashamed of a lot of pastors, the so-called big fathers of the land that cannot speak. We were giving Osibanjo as the vice president. And this is why the Christians were deceived. And Osibanjo, we don't even know whether he's a Christian anymore. The church, who they used that to vote for, because of that, the church voted for them massively. And the guy is doing the bidding of something else. No problem. No problem. We shall decide who sits there. Lift up your hand. We are going to pray for this country. The wicked will never sit on the throne anymore. Enough is enough. People are hungry. People are dying. On top of that, seven insensitive APC governors came and say they are endorsing a president for the second term. Where some people just lost their wife, their children, in a genocide. And somebody is declaring, led by that short Satan El Rufai, And the worst one is those governors in the East that proscribe IPOP. Any governor in your state that refuses to put an anti-grazing law, don't vote for that governor. We will decide who rule in the state, who rule in the center, and who we are sending to anywhere. Lift up your right hand. The blood of the Christians and of the innocent will not be used anymore. They are everywhere. They kill any Christian anywhere. Fulanis are everywhere. So they must not attempt to kill anyone anywhere. We will deploy the constitution and the practice of Jesus and Peter in the early church. Lift up your hands. Say, Nigeria will move forward.
Nigeria will move forward.
And you see, the other time, Donald Trump, God raised him for different purpose. Even though the people who are against the progress of God and the church are fighting him. But the guy might not know what is moving him, but something is moving him. The other day, the guy declared Jerusalem as the capital of Israel. And I learned that some people voted, even Nigeria voted against that. I want to know which of the Nigeria voted. Who did the voting? Because I did not vote. I voted for Jerusalem. We are over 180 million people. So which one decided? Who did the voting? Was it the president? We need to know. I'm saying this to the government of the day. Take the embassy of Nigeria in Israel. Take it to Jerusalem. Jerusalem is the place God has promised for Israel. Lift up your hands. Say, in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Say, Nigeria will move forward.
Nigeria will move forward.
The church of God will move forward.
The church of God will move forward.
Any kingdom.
Any man.
Any government.
That is against the church.
We release.
The anger of God.
Upon them. And their family. By fire. Turn your hands and pray wherever you are. Jesus.
Amen.
Lift up your hands. Jesus did not teach us only to pray. He said, watch and pray. Don't be kind foolishly. You say, I'm a Christian. They slap you one side, you turn the other side. Stop them from slapping at all. The church of God shall move forward.
Amen.
2019 is very close. Get ready. We are not afraid. You know why pastors are quiet? Anybody who speaks, they will come against the person, or they will raise agents that will blackmail the pastor into keeping quiet. No, we are not. We are ready. We are not afraid of any of their antics. You will move forward. Know who you are. I know that we are the light of this world. I've never heard that anywhere that darkness overshadowed the light. It is the light overshadows darkness. You are blessed. Know this anywhere you are. Carry out this evangelism in your head, and when you go, tell people about Jesus and bring them to the kingdom of Jesus and bring them to greater liberation city. God bless you. So shall it be. Lift up your hands.
Levez la main.
You see the way they are attacking churches, attacking pastors. Huh? Some of my children that works on in our media, they tell me how they attack churches, attack men of God. And some of them speak on all kinds of things. But all those crusaders, those demonic, they are too small for me to mention their name. You see demonic occultic people insulting great men of God when they know that their generation will be destroyed of cancer and curses. Time will come, they will look for men of God. No one will be available to help them. You see how they are attacking the church, talking rubbish about tithing, talking rubbish about first fruit. Campaign here till tomorrow, I will pay my tithe. I will give my first fruit. I've increased it. Go to hell. And the same people, you see, they are not talking, saying anything about the massacre going on. Even the media. Also, they are bought over. Lift up your hands. It is well with you. Yeah. If you have your tithe offering, take it and come forward. And be getting ready by the last Sunday of this month. We'll be getting ready for our first fruits. Take it, come forward here. Wherever you are. Lift it up, lift it up, lift it up. Father, behold these hands that are lifted. Whether you're on the way coming, lift it up. They are lifted for signs, they are lifted for wonders. We rebuke the devourer, we rebuke caterpillars over their life. And would declare the blessings of Elohim to come upon them. That the diseases of the Egyptians be far from you. Jesus' mighty name. Drop it on the altar.
Give and it will come back to you. Good measures, press down, shake it together.
Sins. Wash me with the precious blood of Jesus. Take my names away from the book of death. Put my names into the book of life. Amen. Now, I'm encouraging everyone here. That's why we did this prayer together. But you are here. You've not given your life to Jesus Christ. And you know within you, you are struggling with different things. And you are not happy about it. You want to give your life to Jesus and come into a new covenant. And say, from today, I've made up my mind to live according to the laws and the ordinances of our Lord Jesus Christ. You want to rededicate your life? You want to give your life to Jesus? Come forward quickly. I want to pray with you. Please, be fast. This is a time for personal decision. Leave your seat quickly, wherever you are. Run forward to this place. I want to pray with you. Please be fast. Wherever you are. Please stand up and come. Stand up and come forward. Run forward to this place. You say, I am tired. I want to live for Jesus. Please come forward here. Revelation 3:20 said, Jesus is knocking. If you open, it will come in. Come forward, please. Come forward. Come forward. Come forward wherever you are. Wherever you are. Stretch your hands towards me. Please, in case you are watching by television or any of the social media platform, this is your opportunity. This is the moment of decision. Pray along with me. Say after me. Say, Lord Jesus, come into my heart. I repent of my sins. Wash me with the precious blood of Jesus. Take my names away from the book of death. Put my names into the book of life. I will never follow Satan again. I will follow Jesus all the days of my life. If you have said that prayer, you are a new creature. All things have passed away, and all things have become new. Now, any one of you who is struggling to live right, but each time you want to live right, the enemy comes after you. Today, be empowered by the Spirit of God. God will give you the divine ability, the ability of the Spirit to live the life that glorifies God. This is the new covenant. It will speak for you in Jesus' mighty name. Clap for them. I want to personally follow you all, those of you that have given your life to Jesus Christ. I want you to do this. Go to that pastor over there. He will give you a form. We want to use it to be praying with you and to follow you up and to pray you into the giant God wants you to be and praying the promises of God into manifestations in your life. God bless you. We appreciate you for coming out. Thank you. Go this way. We want to follow you up specially. Thank you. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Thank you. Thank you. Is that how to clap? Can you do that better? Lift up your hand. Remember, I meet with newcomers, the first timers, on Monday, and those who are members on Tuesday, and the boat start from 7 a.m. up to 3 p.m. Okay? Did you hear that at all? So, if you are worshiping with us, and this is your first time of worshiping with us in this great city, please stand to your feet, come forward, we want to acknowledge you, we want to pray with you. Come forward, quickly. City, this is the house of God. We are glad to have you. I want to let you know that you are not here by mistake. I welcome you to Greater Liberation City. It's a church of the end time for revival, to reach nations, to depopulate the kingdom of darkness, to set the captive free, and to demystify mystery, to speak the mind of God, and preparing the saints for the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. You are welcome. You are not here by accident, you are not here by mistake, but you are here for the Lord have directed and ordered your step here. And I tell you this, the God, whatever brought you here, this is your last bus stop. And every battle you're going through comes to an end. God will give you testimony. God will give you victory. And God will turn away all your pursuers in the name of Jesus. And testimonies will follow you from now on. Jesus' mighty name. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. You are welcome in Jesus' mighty name. We'd like to meet with you. And those of you worshiping with us here for the first time, would like to meet with me. There is no problem. You go there, they will assist you, give you an appointment, tell you the time when you can meet with me. You don't need to do anything specially concerning that. God bless you as you do so in Jesus' name. I want to know how many of you are visiting us for the first time, but you live within Lagos. You are resident in Lagos. Can you lift up your hands? You're resident within Lagos. Within Lagos, can you lift up your hands? Okay, those of you resident in Lagos, take your personal belongings. Go this way. We have structure to reach those in Lagos and those outside Lagos and those outside Nigeria. Take your personal belongings. Those of you from within Lagos, go this way. Please, quickly, be fast. This way. Those of you from Lagos. We have a structure to reach the people here and the people coming from outside Lagos and outside Nigeria. We appreciate every one of you. That's why we give you special time. God bless you. God bless you. Please, can you move fast? Let there be some sense of urgency. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. You're coming from outside Lagos, but you live in Nigeria. You're coming from outside Lagos? From outside Lagos? From outside Lagos. Lift up your hands. All right. Put it down. You're coming from outside Nigeria. From abroad. Lift up your hands. Lift up your hands. God bless you. All right. You are welcome in Jesus' name. For those of you who would like to see me, they will also assist you in the same manner to see me. We appreciate your time. You travel from afar, from a very long place to come here. Some of you, you did not come for business. You just came for the purpose of worshiping with us and for God touching you. And this we don't take for granted. We appreciate you for coming. God bless you. And let everyone know that God is here. God bless you. So take your personal, your belongings, and go this way. They're going to attend to you. And those of you that want to see me, they will help you arrange it. God bless you. Go this way. Thank you. Thank you. Clap for them. Clap for them. There's a pastor over there. Clap for them. Clap for them. Stand to your feet, everybody.
Thanks, thanks, we give you thanks for all.
For 12,000 mantles. And on Sunday, I will give out 1,000 of those mantles. On Sunday, it is a prophetic mantle of possessing the gates. Lift up your hands.
Levez la main.
I don't want you to be lazy this year. I want you to work for the kingdom that you want. to work for you. The kingdom that is working for you. Lift up your hands. I'm going to give out 1,000 mantles. Now, 1,000 of you, tell people about Jesus Christ, and 1,000 of you, invite every one of you, invite one person each this Sunday. Is it clear? This Sunday. And those that want to see me, they will have the opportunity to do so. And 1,000 of you, God asked me to give you 1,000 mantles. This mantle carries divine protection. This mantle carries prosperity. And this mantle carries divine supply. There are 3 things that God showed me. Put down your hand. How many of you want to pick this mantle on Sunday? How many of you? How many of you? Once that mantle enters your hand, as you live here, heaven will follow you. 1,000 of you, I want to give you the mantle. Is it clear? This Sunday, lift up your hands. Lift up your hands. You will never go down in life. Put your 2 hands over your head. Those of you who want to support our television ministry, beginning from next Sunday, those who want to do TV support, sees me on Sunday after service. Okay? Those who want to do TV support, okay? They will see me on Sundays. So get ready for that anytime you want to do that. The newcomers who want to see me on Mondays. Then those of you who are liberationized here already on Tuesdays. Is that clear? But make sure you are part of a cell group. Okay? Make sure you are part of a what? Cell group. God bless you as you do so in Jesus' name. As you step out, the Lord go with you. The Lord preserve you and keep you. And give you victory this week. That no weapon from the enemy, from the underworld, from your village, from your father's house, from your mother's house, whatever that has been conceived in the womb of time, waiting to happen this week as evil surprises, let it be aborted in the name of Jesus. I take a divine comprehensive insurance of the shed blood of Yeshua HaMashiach over you, your family, your going out, and your coming in from this time forward and forevermore. The peace of Elohim be with you all. Let's share the grace together. Surely, the Lord bless thee and keep thee. The Lord lift up his countenance upon thee and give thee peace from this time forth and forevermore. May the peace of Elohim be with you all from this time forth and forevermore. Remember this, no matter what the matter is, you will matter when it matters most. Jesus loves you, so do I. Shalom. Today's message.